Take a look at these videos. These videos all share a common characteristic. We call this the miniature world or miniature landscape. How are these videos generated? Video generation essentially involves text-to-video and image-to-video. All the videos you are seeing here are generated using the image-to-video method. Therefore, the crucial point of the entire generation process shifts to the image itself. So, how are such images generated? You basically have two generation options. The first is to use a closed source model like NanoBanana. The second is to use an open source model like qwinimageedit. However, regardless of which model you use, the most crucial element is the prompt writing. There is a saying in the field of artificial intelligence, the ceiling of the model is not determined by the model itself, but rather by the way the prompt is written. In other words, it is about how you communicate with the model. So, how should this prompt be written? Let's first look at the prompt engineering workflow. I have prepared both an English and a Chinese version of this prompt engineering workflow for everyone. Prompt engineering refers to using it to help you generate prompts. For example, I can now copy this prompt engineering framework. We can use Gemini within AI Studio to generate the corresponding prompt. You can create a new conversation and then in the model selection, choose Gemini 2.5. This model is currently one of the strongest models in terms of reasoning ability. Then we paste our prompt engineering framework here. Below that, we set a theme. For example, a micropilot preparing for takeoff on a dandelion, and then we generated a prompt. At this point, we can start a new conversation and switch the model. We switch to NanoBanana, then we paste the generated prompt here. Take a look at the result. It is quite good. Besides using closed source models, we can still achieve the desired effect using a ComfyUI workflow. I have also built the workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform via Running Hub II. In the ComfyUI domain, Running Hub is an excellent online workspace because whenever new technologies and models emerge, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description. This grants you 1,000 free credits. Additionally, you get 100 bonus credits just by logging into Running Hub daily, allowing you to try out your own workflows. This workflow is actually very simple. Essentially, it is a standard workflow for qwimage Plus. However, we made a slight modification to it. So now, let's briefly review this workflow. First, there is our main model qwimageedit 2509, which is our so-called Plus version. Then, there is an acceleration model here, utilizing the Lightning 4-step acceleration. I also added a LoRA here. This LoRA is designed to convert anime characters to realistic characters, primarily to enhance the sense of realism in the character's texture. You can replace this with any LoRA used to enhance the realistic feeling. It is flexible to adjust during use. This is our Qwin 2.5 VL encoder, and this is our VAE. Then comes the most core component here, which we call the text encode, qwinimageedit Plus. This node specifically prepared for the Plus model allows uploading 3 reference images. But don't naively assume that you must upload one. As you can see in this workflow, I haven't uploaded any reference images. This means I can treat it as a purely text-to-image model and not necessarily an editing model. Therefore, many people tend to overlook this basic functionality. Or negative prompt is left blank. This is our resolution setting. I am using 1920 by 1080, which is the 16:9 landscape aspect ratio. Next is our sampler. Since we are using an acceleration model, I still used 8 steps here because I find the quality of 4 steps to be slightly inferior. Other settings can be kept as conventional settings. This is the generated result. The most critical thing though is the prompt. Take a look. For the prompt, you have 2 choices. The first is to use the prompt generated by AI Studio earlier to produce the corresponding image. That is fine. However, in this scenario, it is impossible to achieve what we call automated generation. Therefore, we are using the Qwin3 VL model here. We are loading the 4B instruct version here. I have a prompt engineering snippet here. This is the same prompt engineering framework that we introduced earlier. I have divided it into 2 parts, the system instruction and the user input. The upper part is what we call the system prompt, and the lower part is the user's input, pay attention. Currently, my user input is a beautiful female student. Now, look at the result generated when creating the miniature landscape. It is very beautiful. Pay attention to the overall realistic texture. I want to emphasize that if you do not have this realism LoRA, the realistic texture will be slightly diminished. For example, let's generate one, take a look. The generated effect here makes the character look a bit like a toy or a 3D model, right? Therefore, adding such a LoRA sometimes significantly helps in enhancing the sense of realism. Let's return to our core node. How was the prompt written? The initial inspiration came from a post on Twitter. This post actually generated images called fingertip figures. However, the scene in these images is relatively singular. It fixed the entire environment within the space between fingers in that kind of environment. Therefore, the overall visual impact is stronger, but its generalization ability is weaker. When we generate miniature world images, we don't necessarily want them to be strictly placed between fingers. We hope it can perform very well in any scenario. Therefore, I studied his prompt in detail. This prompt can be seen in the image description. The prompt is quite long, but if we summarize it, it still follows a pattern. So, I extracted this pattern and wrote a prompt engineering framework. Now, let's analyze this prompt engineering framework. First is the role definition. We define the role of this large model as a designer of image prompts based on the miniature world concept. We have summarized that it needs to adhere to four principles. The first one is very strong realism. We do not want the generated images to have that toy texture or model texture, making them look less real. Therefore, our first requirement is ultra strong realism. The second principle is the necessity of scale contrast. How do you convey a miniature landscape? You need to have a clear definition of the character's size. To show that something is small, it needs to be contrasted with the surrounding environment. For example, sitting on a book or even standing on a dandelion, these all fall under scale contrast. Utilizing this scale contrast better emphasizes that this is a miniature landscape. The third is a strong sense of narrative. It means we don't want it to be a static object. It should appear to be telling a story. The fourth is technical parameters. What are technical parameters when generating images? In order to ensure it is a realistic image, we usually state what kind of camera the picture was taken with. Therefore, we accurately describe the camera lens and its other parameters. This helps guarantee its realism. Then, we also define 7 modules for the entire command. The first is the core command. Generally, you should start with descriptions like ultra-realistic miniature images or miniature cinematic quality shot. The character description mainly focuses on their size. We usually specify how many centimeters tall, using a precise number to define their size. Next is the scene. In addition, we need to describe the overall action. We also describe the overall lighting and shadow, followed by its material and realistic details. Finally, there are the lens parameters. Onsei, we understand the core principles and the 7 structures. We need to go through 4 steps of consideration. The first is to construct these 7 modules based on the theme I provided. Then combine these 7 modules together to generate a complete prompt. This is the thought process for writing the entire prompt engineering framework. By using such prompts, you can generate various types of miniature world images, and consequently, generate the corresponding videos. Here, we must mention that the emergence of Qwen3 VL has actually brought intelligent features to many workflows, because it can truly be embedded and used within the workflow. So everyone can broaden their thinking and find many application methods. The scenario I discussed today is just one part of this. I hope it has been helpful to you. All right, that is all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.